Welcome to Prophetic Rewind. This is something very dear to my heart, and I have gone back through our archives and found some amazing moments with my dad. Teachings, him traveling and preaching, him on the den, him prophesying, amazing worship moments, and I just knew that I had to share it with you. So I just want to welcome you once again for this week's Prophetic Rewind. Let's go.
I began to realize and understand that this prophetic thing is not just for one or two prophets that will prophesy to presidents or paupers alike. This prophetic mantle must be cast on this nation. The one thing that frustrated the powers of darkness about Jesus, unpredictable. It's called the element of surprise. It's called unaccountable impulse. Everybody say unaccountable impulse. An impulse from God that he is not accountable for. You cannot say, why did you do that? How did you? Can you tell me and give me a reason? God gives no reason to no man. And when you ask him for a reason, he becomes unreasonable. When you ask him for that, he will not give it to you, because God says, it's up to me how I do something. He tells Jesus, go and spit on the ground and put it in his eye. Everybody else that spat on the ground after that tried to make it work. It didn't work, because God is not into methods and into formulas. He's into fresh stuff. How many of you want some fresh stuff? I think America needs some fresh stuff. We're tired of seeing the same old, redundant things being done in the church, redundant things being done in the church. I don't want the same old thing to happen over and over. I think it's time for a change. Can somebody in this building say, it's time for a change? You know why I'm trying to get this into everybody's mind? Because we have lost in America the ability, or yes, the ability to do something unusual within the environment of the of our gatherings. We are so predictable. You know, I'd like to just walk down here and pull somebody out. The lady with the red shirt there, by the way, the one with the folded arms. Stand up. It's just something that I cannot stand when we have creative, listen to me, creative power flowing through this building and we don't even use it. We say, well, let's hope the prophet will give us a word. Let's hope the prophet will say something to us. No, God's speaking right now. But you're scared of the unknown. No, you're not. There's a treasure in an unknown place. God said, there's a treasure. Who did you come with tonight? Who did you come with tonight? The one on your right. Stand up, please, as well. Because there's going to be a double miracle that's going to happen tonight. God's going to do a double miracle tonight. Because he has chosen you, the one, not the red, the lady in the red, I'm coming to you in a minute. He has chosen you to do something very, very unusual. And there are a few opposing forces. And there are legal aspects to this word, where you will be facing a legal situation. The Spirit of God tells me to tell you that when this happens, you are going to have one victory after the other. Dave, turn me up a little more. You're going to have one victory after the other. It's going to happen one after the other. You're not going to go through fights. You're not going to go through a loss of money. But something's going to be handed into your hand. It's going to be placed there. Because you know what God says? A double miracle that you may not even know much of it right now. But it will be placed into your hands. And when it's placed into your hands, you will literally say, I'm going to do something with this that's been given to me, this favor. I'm looking at a piece of property right now as I see it. And God said, this will be unlocked, because there are keys tonight that are being given to potential clients of mine, says the Lord. Clients, yes, because I want you to know I'm going to use you with this property issue. People will say, you could never be the person to do it. But there's a property, and you're going to put your feet on that property, and you're going to say, it's mine, and it's for us, and we're not going to give it up, because we've given up enough. Enough is enough, says the Lord. Favor is being given to you tonight, says the Spirit of God. Come on. Keep praying with me, everybody. Keep praying with me. Come on. Lady in red, I'm ready for you. Ready for you. Come on, let's pray. There's somebody's sister. Somebody's sister who is extremely ill right now. And I need to pray for her. I need to pray for Jean. I don't know who Jean is, but somebody may know this person. If you know Jean or you are Jean, would you wave your hand to me, please, right now? If you know anybody by that name, can you come down to the front, please, right now? And I want you to give God a big hand, because I'm telling you. Come on, let's pray together. Everybody keep praying with me. Come on, let's pray. Hello, Jean. Are you Jean? Come up here, please. Are you okay? Okay. Let's stand over there. Okay, let's pray for the lady in red. This night, I smile upon you, says the Lord. Tonight, I am sharing my secret with you. Tonight, I'm sharing something with you. I'm sharing something with you that is going to help you live for a long life. So, but how much longer can I live? You can live for decades. But for what purpose? So you will break the curse by outliving every single member of your family in the past. You will outlive them. You will have favor. You will have life. And God says, you will break a curse. Then it'll start spreading to a young man who will be greatly touched by my spirit, who will say, I've taken the keys and I've taken what is mine. Because God says, your prayers are my prayers, and your faith is my faith. But this night, you will live decades to see victory upon victory in your household, because it shall be called a household of faith. It shall be called a household of righteousness. And everyone, I see six people that will be raised up and be used by the Spirit of God to extend the kingdom, and you live to see each one of them doing it, says the Lord. Come on. Come on, give them a shout of praise. Come on, let's pray together. Keep praying with me. Why don't we all stand up just for a few more minutes? While God says a few good little things here. How many of you like God to say a good little thing to you? The element of surprise. Come on, Garland, come up here. Are you okay with your... Come on, come up here. I want you to pray with me tonight. Let's stand and let's pray. Raise your hands up. I'm going to just take a little walk, okay? Can I do that? Dave Smith, can I do that? Am I okay there? Okay. Come on, let's lift our hands and pray. Michael. Who is Michael? Who's praying for Michael? Yes, your son. I want to pray for him right now. God's going to do something big. What are you believing for?
Deliverance.
Where is he right now? Okay, wait. There's somebody else. You as well. Are you okay?
I'm praying.
Are you praying? Okay, pray then. Go. Well, that's fine. That's something you should do. Okay, you are?
I've been praying for Michael, my next door neighbor.
Okay.
He had brain damage.
Come here. I want you to come up here. Come up here. So people can hear this and we can see it. Come on, everybody, let's give him a shout of praise. You praying for Gene? What are you praying for? But what for? Give me a specific. I'll give you the rest. What do you want to be? Okay, that's all I need to. How many children does she have? Okay, four. The third child, The third child is what I must, pray for. Everybody pray with me as we believe this right now. The third, not the fourth one, the third child. I want to pray for something very unusual to happen tonight. Because how old is, do you know, how many, is it boys and girls? Okay. And how old is he? Okay. Let me tell you something. Something is going to happen in that boy's life. Something very big and something very unusual. And it's going to affect his father. Or his father's, yes, his father's family are going to be affected by this happening. Who is the father? Where is the father? So he's, but the 26-year-old boy, is there a 24-year-old? Okay, so it's 26, and what's the younger one? Okay, we're 24, 25, that's what I'm talking about. Yes, I want to pray for that child as well. There's something very big that's going to take place between them. Something. You say, okay, can you tell me more? No, because that's called the unknown. And I may have an idea. But this is going to affect the man. Because the man has a serious problem. He does. Jean's husband. And God says, you don't even know this, but there has been a physical problem that he has. But God will do a miracle for him, an unusual miracle, because of the connection with a 26-year-old. Because there's going to be a wonderful deliverance. Jean has prayed. She has been scarred. There are bruises. God said, enough of this. I will take verbal abuse, control, and break it over her life. Once and for all, it shall be done. But the 26-year-old. Who, did one of them have a child that's, that just recently?
Yes. And I do too.
So you, there's a, one that was just recently born? Which child gave forth, brought that child forth? Her daughter, and that's the one that's 24, 25? Okay. Let me tell you something. It's okay. This night, God has singled each one of them out to use them. But God said, Jean will be there to see it. And God said, I'll raise up that man. And I'll cause one, that one child that Jean has, her daughter has given her a grandchild, but you also have a grandchild that was just born. You know what God just said to me? Two of them together will take the kingdom by force. Two of them together will take the kingdom by force, says the Lord. And God said, I raise them up at the same time. I'll put my spirit upon them like a Joshua and a Caleb. For this night, I say to you, nothing shall break the bond between them. And your sister shall live to see it. And a union shall take place because of this, says the Lord. Come on. Come on. Give God a shout of praise. That's beautiful. Alice, what is your name, man? Come, you're out. You got it tonight, you're in trouble. I'm gonna tell you all your sins. I'm joking, come on. Okay, let's get their hands. You are praying for Michael. You told me he's a next door neighbor. Okay, well, let me just start just wait, because something's happening here. Come on, keep praying with me. There's been a continual attack against this family. I mean, just one thing after the other. And God is working right now. He has to. He has no choice. Because the enemy said, I'll take your head and I'll punch it in. And I'll take you out with no brain. God says, I'm going to do something unusual. Your prayers will break the curse of a neighbor that seems to be dying, but God said will be raised back up. This night, the curse has been broken. Come on, hallelujah, come on. Yes, yes, come on. This is gonna happen. Keep praying with me. A September birthday, a September birthday. Kimberly, I think. Just keep praying with me. I'm getting it, getting it. Someone in their family has a birthday in September. I don't know who it is. By the way, what's wrong with Michael?
He was brain damaged. And his mother also has moved in with our next door neighbor. The son, which is Michael, in his 40s, was brain damaged.
That's exactly what God said.
His mother has, they've both moved in with our next door neighbor. She has Alzheimer's, and I've been praying.
Listen.
And I pray every day, Lord, I believe in recreative miracles. And I
you, you are a soldier. You are a huge soldier in the kingdom. I can see it. And God said, you have not done this in vain. I spoke about that curse that kept coming, and it's all to do with the brain. And God said, I'm going to bash you till you got no brain, which speaks of Alzheimer's. God, that dementia. I want to pray against that because I truly, truly believe that this night a double portion is going to take place. Come on. Hallelujah. Yes. Shout. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There's somebody here that has a family member that's in a strange cult. Really strange cult. You're really concerned about it. And there was September. I don't think it was connected. Yeah, it was September. Someone in the house. Where's the Michael lady? Somebody in that house that has a September. Just check on that for me. Some connection to September, okay? Everybody keep praying. Let's just get this out. Let's get God's word out. Come on, let's believe him tonight. Somebody that's in a strange cult. And there could be a bunch of people, but I pinpoint it as I get into it. Somebody has a friend or a family member. Come out here, please. You stand proxy. Come on. Lift your hands up, everybody, and say, I believe tonight that God can do anything. Anything. Come on. There's an older woman that I'm concerned about right now. An older woman. She's living in the upper regions of New York. Somebody that has a person in the upper regions of New York. What are you for? Come up here. That's what it is. Come. Everybody raise your hands to pray. What are you praying for?
For my husband.
Okay. That's all. Okay, let's pray together. There's a connection, come back here, in the upper regions of New York. In other words, the northern part, I think it's called it upper state or northern state or something. Upstate. Who lives, who knows anybody in upstate New York? Wave your hand right now. I want all of you to come down to the front, please, right now. We're going to make a declaration. And I want everybody in this house to believe that because you are present with the prophet, you're going to leave this building tonight with a word of victory and freedom and deliverance for anybody you meet in the next few days. Come on. Who are you praying for? Oh, who's in
I have a cousin from New York State, and I haven't talked to her in a long time.
A daughter?
A cousin.
Okay. And what can you tell me about them? Okay. Okay. Let's pray for them. Let's just stand together with us.
I have a friend in upstate New York who's taking me to England.
Okay. You have a friend in upstate New York. Is the lady? And she is. She has a son?
Yes.
Where is her son right now? Somebody lives overseas. Somebody lives overseas. Keep praying with me. I'm just hearing a little death there. Death. Somebody has a death notice, prognosis. Not long. Besides that one person, there's another one. They said, just a matter of time. I don't like that just a matter of time crap. There's no such thing in the kingdom. Did you hear what I said? Just a matter of time, you're going to be raised up. Just a matter of time, you're going to be set free. In just a matter of time, you're going to be filled with the Holy Spirit. That's the matter of time that I know about. And if you want to be in agreement with me about that matter of time, we'll break the doctor's matter of time. Come on! Hallelujah! Just a matter of time, freedom will come. Just a matter of time, freedom will come. Say it. Oh, listen to Nashville. Turn and tell somebody, just a matter of time. You gotta tell somebody. One more time. Just a matter of time. I'm going to do something this weekend. I'm going to deal with eternity. Eternity is a very valuable asset, a very valuable force that you have in your DNA. Do you know, I read in Time magazine, they say, out of Proverbs, this is Time magazine, where it says, God, everything in its time is beautiful, and He has placed eternity in man's heart, or men's heart. You know what the word heart is? DNA. Your genetic information contains one little characteristic, eternity. Therefore, men, women, human beings will never be happy until they taste something eternal. They try here, they try there, and only when they meet eternal Christ, eternal God, are they satisfied. And then eternity meets eternity, and God removes any parental curses and gives you something called new life. How many of this building have that new life? Come on. Lift your hands and pray. Okay, your husband. Okay, you told me it was Freemasonry. And this night, God says, don't even be concerned about it. Because there is a certain book that he has read that has really frustrated him. I could tell you the title if I could just see the rest of it, but I'm a little bad-sided right now. But I can see that there's something he read. And I think it was around 1968 is when this was either released, or there's something about 1968. But the Spirit of God says, I'm going to break the power of that, and I'm going to introduce him to something greater than the pact that he has already entered into and the covenant that he has already made. How many children do you have? Okay. Your youngest child. Who is your youngest child? Is this a little girl? Okay. Your youngest child. Because I saw a girl. Your youngest child is an obnoxious force to the powers of hell. Let me tell you something. Rowdy, unafraid, will open her mouth and say it exactly the way it is. How old is Elizabeth? Seven. How old is my Elizabeth? Eight. Elizabeth is seven. Elizabeth is going to bring something unusual into your house, and this man will be touched deeply, and there will be a high priest raised up. Not a priest of Freemasonry, but a priest of Christ. I prophesy that. I predict that. And this child shall see the truth. But this book that he read. I don't know when was he born? Do you know when he was born? You must know, of course. Okay, 1961. And it was 1968 that something was read or something was seen. I'm going to deal with 1968 quickly. Everybody pray with me.
Come on.
There are three people around him in 1968. One was a strong figure, too strong, and then gone. And God says, I want you to know that I did look over him and take care of that whole family. But this Jennings, this name that I keep hearing as I'm standing before you, was either somebody at school or somebody in his life that affected him. Father, I'm committing this to you. I'm commanding that the power of this thing be broken once and for all, and this man be released into a freedom of the Spirit, and this household declare his glory in the name of Jesus. You've got it. Come on, let's pray together. Which child is 14? A 14-year-old?
Katie.
You'll get a 14-year-old. This and this. Do you have a boy?
No, my husband's kids.
Okay. Don't tell me anymore. Katie is what you just said to me. I'm going to give you a word. This whole family, your whole family, have been put aside for a season, only to be brought back into the highlights of the kingdom. I'm prophesying and helping you tonight, because there's one child that has a powerful prophetic anointing. Elizabeth's one of them. Katie will write. Katie will put down on paper what is in her heart. Everybody pray with me. Keep praying, everybody, please. Let me pray for, was it Stephen? Was it Stephen? 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 Stephen?
Come on.
Stephen?
Yes.
Stephen?
Yes.
Stephen?
Yes.
Be raised up. Be raised up as a voice to speak from the pulpits of many nations. I anoint you for that in the name of Jesus. That's beautiful. Come on, give him praise tonight. Come on. Not that you know of. Alicia, come here. Come stand over here. I think I've prayed for you before. Okay, let's pray for you. I notice you do this a lot. Is it when you're praying?
Or do you?
Okay. Okay. Give me your hand, please. God says you've been verbally spoken to in a way that does not suit the way you live. And there have been times in your life where you, well, let me just say it like it is. The enemy would like you to take your life. Just take, not now. He would like it to have happened twice before, where he put a suicidal force by your side, in your bed, and you slept with suicide, you slept with death. But God said, I saved you from that. I brought you out. Not for you to say, I don't know if I can, or I don't think I'm worthy. Yes, you are. Okay? Is that okay? Okay, well, give me your hand again then. Father, let this woman understand that the things that happen in her life will only help her in the end. Helping you, fighting for you. Hey, the United Kingdom. That's where it's going to happen. Says the Lord. Come on. Good God. Come on. God said, go, for I shall do something unusual over the seas. You work it out, it shall be done, and I'll make a way, says the Lord. Come on. What is that about? Listen to this. Listen to this beautiful thing. Just say what you just said.
I've been wanting to go for 30 years. I have a real love for the people of Britain and Wales. And God has just used my girlfriend from upstate New York to offer me a free trip.
Come on! It may be small in your eyes, but let me tell you something. That's big for her. God has set it aside. How many of you know the door's opening right now so you can run through it? Come on! Hallelujah! Run! Run through a troop. Leap over a wall tonight. God. The spirit is so good, so alive. Go enjoy. Enjoy it. Wait. It was a good word. You don't even realize it. You have a, God has a plan for you now. Who did you come with tonight? Have you been married? And that's where a lot of the pain took place. Now, let's wipe that slate. Now, big things happen. Your daughter here tonight? Is your daughter here? Okay. She's next door. Where are you from? Missouri. Well, welcome here now. Now, we're not going to let you go feeling anything else but freedom and joy. Lift your hands, everybody. Tonight, the Lord says to you, I've given you precious commodities. But did you come from Michael? Your son, Michael. I remember that when I was down there because I stood right next to you. And I remember the Lord saying to me, he's not here, he's away. But his state of existence is the term of his state of existence. Minnesota. Who? You? Minnesota, it's happening right now. It's happening right in this very second. God is doing something. When I say doing something, I can describe 1,000 things. But there's a party. There's a party coming up. Someone's birthday. And God tells me to tell you that there are good things going to happen in Minnesota. Now you can say, well, isn't there more? Well, go and find out. God will tell you the rest. But very good things. Good news. Bells are ringing. It gets better. Oh, well, that's all I'm going to tell you. But just expect Montana. Montana. Who's in Montana? Michael is in Montana. It's happening right now. God is taking me geographically and telling you there must be a move out. But God said, I'll work it out, and then his state of existence spiritually will change overnight. Go your way. He's done it. Come on. Okay. Where's your mother and your father? Where do they live? New Orleans. Do you know what God said tonight about New Orleans? Did you already said New Orleans to Dallas? That connects with you. And there's a man from New Orleans, has great authority. And I knew I called you for a reason. So I want you to come stand over here. Okay. Your parents are in New Orleans. And you? You're here. Okay. What are you doing here? Okay. Good stuff. Good for you. Are you graduating? And you're going to get out. You're going to stay here. There's something big about the connection between Tennessee, Texas, and Louisiana. There's something going on there. I can't tell you what it is. I don't want to work it out, But it's called the unaccountable impulse. God says it, he just says, sorry, that's what I said, I'm not going to tell you why. But this man is an authority and a gatekeeper in New Orleans. He's a gatekeeper. And he is going to pray with me now that there be a great eruption that'll take place in your family that'll bring one miracle after the other. Stretch your hands out to her, God, and let's pray together. Father, you've given this girl promise after promise. You called out by name tonight. Now God says, relax. I'm going to send my word into New Orleans and a miracle will happen. Then another, says the Lord. And it shall be so in the name of Christ. Come on! Let's give him a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Okay. It's done, it's done, it's done. And you will make declaration of my kingdom wherever I send you, not to be controlled by anybody, says the Lord. What were you praying for again? What did you ask for? For what? A curse, okay. Everybody in the house, stretch your hands up to God. I stretch my hands to all of these that are standing, your friend, in upstate New York, or it doesn't matter what it is. I want everyone in the house to say these words. The heavens have opened up for me. The heavens have opened up for my house. His word is working at this very moment. I have faith, not a faith that has worked only, but a faith that is about to work. A higher level. I receive the promise of the Lord tonight. It's done. Now give him a shout of praise and I release it upon your house. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give him one more shout of praise. He deserves it. You may be seated.
Thank you so much for watching and thank you for going back in time with me and having these incredible moments with my dad. You know, one thing about my dad is that he was one of a kind. And I'll tell you something, he is irreplaceable. And he was a precious and beautiful gift. And the passion of my heart is to put out there as much as I can of what he did. Because my father labored for 40 years. He traveled all over the world, to countries all over the world, all over the United States. And I have found in our archives some incredible, incredible moments that you have never seen. And so that's why I'm doing this. I'm sharing this because there are prophetic moments and words that, even though he said it years ago, are relevant right now for the time that we're living in. I'm so passionate about getting that out there, getting that to you to see these moments, to hear these insights. And in order to do that, I need your support too. And so if you're enjoying these prophetic rewinds, if you like traveling through time with me and seeing my father in the past, if this is blessing you and blessing your life, and especially, we put these out on a Monday because I know that this is the beginning of your week and I want you to be inspired as you go into your week and that you have a prophetic mindset, a prophetic insight, something to drive you as you go through your week because life is hard. Your support is an offering to God. It's an offering to God, and it also supports me in what I'm doing and trying to get as much of my dad out there and what he did and share it with the world. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart.